Howdy and welcome to Let's Play IL-2 Stormovic. We're actually not gonna play IL-2 Stormovic. We're gonna watch the gameplay itself, mission 179. We're gonna let the autopilot do his thing with our jet here, and we're gonna try to see what we can learn from it. If the autopilot succeeds the mission, then I'm gonna move on. If he fails, I'm just gonna play this mission myself. Bartels awarded Iron Cross 2nd Class, Seidel joining the squadron April 10th, 1945, 4:15 in the afternoon. Weather is blind, clouds at 1100. Increased VVS activity has been noted around Zalo. Pay special attention to the protection of the bridges. Russians are attacking them daily. If VVS appear, target the leaders. Distance is very short. Zalo is right here, just north of our city. And altitude is 2500. We'll be flying above the clouds. What is blind? What does that mean? I think that means a lot of clouds, thick clouds, maybe fog and mist as well. Probably not rain, I don't know. Otherwise it'll say rain or thunderstorm. All 8 of us taking off. We'll take maybe 50% fuel. That's probably more than enough to get us to Zalo and back. The Zalo is this town right here, just north of us. And Zalo Heights are the mountains right here. There's a big mountain range. Doesn't look like much on this map. It's just two little gray blobs here. But on the actual map, on the ground, all the huge mountain ranges. I often navigate by those mountain ranges. I found them as the most useful landmarks on this map. I usually get myself there, and then I orient myself north, south, east, or west, depending on where I need to go. Like if I get to the mountains and if I need to go to our airbase, I'll fly south of the mountains and I'll find our airbase. Here, the north of the mountains and the east of the city, there'll be two bridges. One's the Gray Bridge here, which is the railroad. It'll look like wooden bridge on the actual map. And here, this is the yellow road, which is the car road, the tarmac, the gray bridge. We'll see if we ever get there. So all we gotta do is fly north. One thing I don't understand is how we're gonna fly above the clouds and try to spot the bridge or the bombers, who I'm gonna be assuming they'll be flying below the clouds, because they're gonna have to bomb the bridge. So if I were to bomb the bridge, I would fly below the clouds. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to find the bridges. So there's the 8 of us plus 4 FW-190s. I'm gonna jump back into the cockpit and turn on the autopilot, and we'll see what he does. So he just lowered the flaps to take off position. He's starting the left engine. It's just the same procedures that I usually do. He's now just starting the right engine. Anything up in the sky? Just a lot of clouds. So the weather is actually great down here on the ground. It's actually a great day to go for a run or something. So there's no sun. There's something up in the sky. FW-190s. They're escorting a couple of GU-88 back there behind us. So these guys are the 88's gonna go bomb something on the enemy territory, and the two FW-190s are the escorts. So it's throttling up quite fast. Actually, I can't throttle up that fast. Now the wheel breakdown. He's just let go of the wheel brakes, centering himself with the yaw. Full throttle. He's up in the air now. He's gonna raise the landing gear. Let's also bring up the map here. The blue button is the landing gear button. The red ones are the flaps. These are the flaps we can barely see right here. Just raised up the flaps. Still going full throttle. It's not climbing up that much. It's actually descending at this point. You want to hold just after the steady at least to get some speed. So these are the 88s behind us, above us actually, and the FU-190s back there, or back down there somewhere. And this is my number 2 taking off, my number 3 taking off, my number 4 on the ground. We're turning northward. Waypoint number 3. Waypoint number 4. Now it's to 900. I just missed it, apparently, so he's gonna circle around. This is fine. This is a great view of Frankfurt under order. We're flying extremely low for some reason. Just trying to hit waypoint number 3. It's gonna climb out to altitude 900. It's climbing up to altitude 1600. So the 88s are going up north somewhere. They're gonna be bombing maybe this thing. I don't know. But here come the enemies. There's 4+4 enemy bombers coming to the bridge. They're gonna get to the bridge before we get there. Yeah, the weather is blind. This was what they mean by blind. We're flying in the clouds. There's yellow heights down there. The river we should follow. And the bridge will be right here. Some time compression. This guy's rolling like a maniac. It's the only way you can spot things below you. Just roll left and right. I mean, you can't see below you. These guys bombed the bridge already. That's the bridge. There they are. It looks like they're shooting at the bridge. They're not bombing it. Maybe they're not carrying bombs. I don't know. I think that's a bomb right there. Maybe they just missed. But these are IL-2s. 4 IL-2s right there. They do have rear gunner. Whoa. Jeez. There are 4 more guys coming. These guys are making their attack on the bridge. So IL-2s, they have brick guns and gun. They have right here, off topic. That was the leading edge slats. It helps us when we're losing too much speed, and we need to grab more air. As I was saying, IL-2s are great planes with the deadly guns. But they're best known for their armor. Their armor's extremely sturdy. It's a little too close, dude. But they are no match for our cannons. Our cannons will snap their planes in half. Just one or two shots. But IL-2s are known for their great armor. They're built like tanks. They're built better than tanks. But they are still no match for 30mm cannons. Oh, is that someone else shot? This guy's using his flaps to do something. I don't know. To do a loop. To the half loop there. It's now descending. The 4 enemies here. One's going down apparently. And 4 enemies over there. Boom, boom, boom. It's looking pretty good. There's a 2 pilots. Build out from that IL-2. IL-2s make a big splash whenever you hit them or whenever they explode. Doing pretty good. I can't really keep up with what's going on. But there's a lot of us here. There's a 12 of us. It's not a fair match. There's a FW-190 is helping us out. Here the 88 is going to bomb something. BF-109 is where they're gonna come from. I don't know, they are still in single four formation. Flying in style. It's possible that they're not seeing any of us down here. Looks like this mission's gonna be a great success. There's two, three more enemies down there. Leading as slats coming out once again. GF4 nice at them. Big splash, that's an IL-2 going down. Another big splash. Alright, this is all yours, autopilot. Bam! I had no chance. That's it. That's our job. Our job's done. We're gonna go home. It's a good job, autopilot. So we can go take a look at the JU-88. Everything. 190s. They just dropped their bombs? Well, they dropped some of their bombs. Okay. Here they go. So I don't know how you're supposed to see what you're bombing down there. But they're gonna... they're bombing this this airbase down there. Can't see much. It's the airbase down there. What's the fuck out there? Triple A's. There's an airplane down there. But their job is done. They're gonna go home. I don't know what these guys were doing. The PF-109s. These guys. They're gonna maybe land at our airbase as well. I don't know. But we're done. I'm gonna circle around here. Any enemy airplanes? What am I looking at here? This is the bridge we're supposed to protect, I guess. The bridge is fine. Three IL-2s went down there. Nothing else to be seen here. VF-109s. Us. Let's go home. So whenever I go back into the cockpit, the autopilot turns itself off. So I'm gonna turn it back on. I'm gonna go home. Weaving left and right, trying to hit the waypoints. There is time skip in this game. I use it. And it'll, this time skip will stop when it gets to the next waypoint. Or if they're near an enemy. Alright. Flying like a drunken pilot. Oh, here we go. Now we're on the landing. The throttle's way down. Just keeping speed up at 300-400 kilometers per hour. We may or may not land on this pass. Yeah, to the 600 speed, 350. To the 450. Up to the 400 speed, 350. Alright, he's gonna surf around. Alright, I think we're gonna land this time. There's no one in front of us. Altitude 600, speed 350. Losing speed. Throttle's way down. Not all the way down, but it's way down. Altitude 450, speed still 350. We're lined up. Lower this landing gear before his flaps. Altitude 250, speed 250. Lowering the flaps. Circling around. Altitude 180, speed 180. Altitude 150, speed 160. Or the flaps all the way. Aiming. Flaps coming out. Easy landing. Just turned off both engines. Alright, that was pretty good. The mission was pretty easy to begin with. There were only four, there were eight IL-2s unescorted. And their focus was on the bomb, on the bridge. And they didn't even have bombs, they had rockets and guns. So they probably couldn't have succeeded in their missions anyway. And then we had 8 of ME-262s, and 8 ME-262s against 8 IL-2s. That's not a fair match. Maybe 2 ME-262s and 8 IL-2s, that's more of a fair match. And then we had the F-30-190s, and then we had the F-30-190s from this flight come to help us out. And then we have BF-109s, although they didn't do anything at all. What happened to this guy? I don't know, this crazy guy. Alright. Mouse got killed in action? That's not cool. Bartel, 4 kills. Our autopilot got 1 kill, Schumacher got 1 kill, and F-3190, one of them got shot down here, another one got shot down there, and the JU-8H destroyed some AAAs out here. We lost 3 planes, 1 ME-262 and 2 F-3190s, and then enemy lost all 8 of the IL-2s. The bridge still stands. Is complete success.